If you're looking to manage your personal life in ClickUp, you have come to the right place. Normally on this channel, I release videos 2 times a week, every single week, talking about how to use ClickUp's newest features or systems that you can then put into ClickUp by defining your workflows and processes. This week, I thought I'd go into the unknown, if you will, of ClickUp land and try to tackle what to me is the most complicated process in any person's life, which is adulting. Right, the act of being an adult, of doing the mundane and boring things associated with being a human adult in society. And to make this a little bit less painful, I thought, of course, ClickUp could help us make it happen. So in this video, I'm gonna be taking you behind the scenes in how I'm organizing our little household here inside ClickUp. I'm also gonna talk about some of the FAQs I get about using ClickUp for your personal life. And finally, I'm gonna give you some suggestions, 12 suggestions for little adulting tasks you might wanna consider adding if you're looking to start organizing your life in ClickUp or really any tool, and you wanna make sure you're kind of checking those adulting boxes as we're doing, you know, our adulting things. And if you're not already aware, this video is part of a series of videos talking about personal productivity and personal use of ClickUp here in January. So if you'd like to see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe down below and hit the bell so you're actually notified about new videos coming out. If you do not hit the bell and you just hit subscribe, you're probably not gonna hear about these videos, just a heads up. All right, so let's dive in to my ClickUp and I'll show you exactly how I'm organizing my personal life inside of ClickUp. So what I have is one folder here, and that folder has 3 lists. It's really actually not that impressive. The 3 lists don't really have too many fancy setups, too many fancy custom fields. There's really just one custom field that runs throughout this entire thing, which you can see if I go here by category, you can see the different custom fields that kind of help organize our tasks. While this really doesn't provide any utility, it just helps me segment my tasks into groups, which you can see I have some of them collapsed here just to make it a little bit easier for showing you guys here, because I don't need you to see all of my stuff. And just a brief commentary here, you're probably not surprised to see that I have a relatively simple area in my personal organization of ClickUp. I don't need to overcomplicate things here. And often when I see people kind of struggle with organizing their personal life in ClickUp, it's because they're applying work principles to home life and they're making things super, super overly complicated. And it makes it hard for other people, especially people in your household, your kids, if you're trying to get them to collaborate with you, it makes it harder for other people to catch on. So I've kept things really, really simple here. So it's a little bit friendlier to my partner who is not quite as tech forward as I am. But yeah, so routines and improvements. If you haven't seen my other videos talking about routines and improvements, I'll link it up at the top here. It's more for a business application, but it applies to personal use as well. So if I actually show the task location here, you'll have a better sense of where everything falls here. So we've got improvements, routines, and so on. Improvements are basically one-time tasks, tasks that once I do them, they're done, hurrah, nothing else I need to worry about. Whereas routines, like replacing the coffee filter, it's basically an indication that it's an ongoing task that needs to happen. And while yes, you could probably call me out and say, well, why do you need to have these two categories if the only difference is due date? It's more of just a mental thing to keep track of where am I trying to grow versus when am I trying to maintain. If I have too many maintenance tasks, it makes me feel like I'm stagnating. So I always try to have more and more improvement tasks, more so on the business side, but increasingly on the personal one as well. You'll see we don't actually have a lot here right now because this home reno, this entire project is a form of a improvement project. And so we have a pretty light list in the improvements area right now, just because this is taking up all of our personal brain space. But anyway, right below improvements, we have someday inbox. And if you're not familiar with the idea of an inbox, it's kind of this idea of creating a dumping ground for your tasks and sorting them before they actually become tasks. And when we decide we're actually going to do that idea, that's when we drag that into an improvement or a routine list. If we're just kind of leave it here, we might just leave it in the considering doing bucket for a long period of time. And that's perfectly okay too. The main reason to have an inbox like this is just to have a quick dumping ground in case you're not sure where to go with something. And also to encourage you to not overcommit, because by putting things here, you have to reflect on them before you say, yeah, I'm actually gonna do that. And I like that separation for myself. So I've implemented that in my personal life here as well. You can see this someday list is actually pretty darn small because once again, our entire lives are consumed by a home renovation project. Ooh, and on that note, if you'd like to learn how I'm organizing a home renovation in ClickUp, also how we're selling our house, moving across country, and organizing all that in ClickUp, just comment on this video and let me know, because I'd be happy to release a video on that. Maybe later this month, I don't know, we'll see when I actually have brain space and if you guys are interested in it. But yeah, that's the basic structure. Now, a question that typically comes up around this point is something like,
well, how do you use this with your partner? Is your partner inside ClickUp?
I don't technically need to have my other household members inside my ClickUp to make this work. I could use a custom field, create a label, or something like that, or a team assignee, and make my tasks assigned to that placeholder rather than actually using an assignee. However, I am lucky here that my spouse is willing to use ClickUp, which makes this whole setup a little bit easier. So rather than having to do some kind of fancy configuration of custom fields, I can simply invite him as a guest to ClickUp and then assign tasks to him, and there we go. And I should note, he's not often logging into the system. More often, he'll look at the daily kind of daily reminder emails he gets from ClickUp and use that kind of to manage his day. If he finishes something, he'll either let me know or he'll click directly from that email into the task, making it a super kind of low-tech experience for his side of things. Let's go back to the overall folder here, and I just want to wrap up with a conversation about views, because that is the last element of setting up this template and the element that I think most people just overlook or completely skip. These views allow me to have different slices and dices of information, which I talk about a lot more in the views video, which I can link above. And these make it really easy for anyone to look at these words and understand, oh, if I click on this, it'll show me all my tasks by category. Great. These simplify the navigation for folks who aren't quite so comfortable using ClickUp. My task by status is what I have set up as the default view for everyone. This is where someone will go if they just click on the folder, which is why it's what I saw first when I clicked on it. Inside here, the main settings I have are sorting by due date. Meaning from top to bottom, the most recent or soon to be due task shows up at the top. I could change that order here if I wanted to, but I'm pretty good with the way it is. Next to that is group by status. In board view, group by means what are these little headers that we are working between. And I wanted to group by status, so that's what I did. I could also choose to group by assignee or something else, but for me, status is nice and simple, makes it easy for anyone to understand or drag and drop things between. Next, we have subtasks as separate. Because some of our tasks do have subtasks and I didn't want to have any confusion with subtasks being missed along the way, I made sure all subtasks are showing up as separate tasks. And if there is a subtask, it would show up here just the same as any other task. Finally, I have this set to me mode to make sure that whoever's clicking on this, they only see tasks assigned to them. If you're not already aware, me mode is something that you can, set throughout your ClickUp experience, but when you're setting up a view, you can actually set this up right here so that anytime someone clicks on this view, it flips them to me mode, even if they're not normally in it. And in case you're curious, you can also get to me mode by clicking on filter by where assignee is me mode. And that'll assure it doesn't actually flip them to overall me mode, but just show them based on these results, what tasks are showing up assigned to them. It's a slightly different way to do it. And this way would be a little bit more courteous if you didn't want me mode to follow them every single place they went in ClickUp afterwards. Bit of a nuanced difference there. So just leave me a comment if you have any questions about this guy. After this main default view, I have a list by category, and this is pretty darn simple. Again, it's sorted by due date, most recent at the top. In this area, I have things grouped by the category called life category. This is a drop-down custom field that you can see right here that'll help me move things between different sections. This is simply for a visual breakdown. It really doesn't have any other role. And then within these sections, I have things grouped by due date, where the most recent or soon to be done task is at the top, and the one below it is below that. Here I have subtasks kept where they are because I find it pretty easy to navigate in list view. And then I actually have two other views up here, which I won't go into, but just breaking things down by person, who's assigned what. This is really great when I'm trying to, even out the load, if you will. If one of us is feeling overwhelmed by the adulting tasks on our plate, we might just look here to give a quick gut check over what we have assigned to each of us. And missing date, this is mostly for me just to make sure that every single task in our area has a due date and an assignee. Oh, and you'll notice here, we also have time estimate and dollar estimate. We're not meticulous about tracking any of this stuff. This is just kind of giving us a sense of maybe our budget for recurring expenses or just how many hours of adulting we need to do to motivate ourselves to just get it done. Now, this might be a little bit too simple, but I have to admit that this is a pretty helpful way that we have found to organize all of those silly recurring tasks that it's really hard to keep track of. And the more stuff we have, which we try to get rid of a lot, but no matter how little stuff you have, there's always those recurring routine maintenance tasks. And this has been our way of keeping track of all those things. It hasn't been perfect, but it's been a lot easier than just trying to remember it or to panic when you forget to do the thing later. Now, notice I have this in its own space. You do not need to have this structure in its own space. You could just have this folder be private, but put in your main work area if you have one or two spaces as your overall work area. The reason I have it as a separate space, simply for the separation, the division of church and state, if you will, and to just have less click apps enabled to make it a little bit of a snappier experience. So you'll see if I go into the space here and I go to space settings, the number of click apps I have on here are definitely not all of them. And just as a bit of a disclaimer, in the process-driven workspace, we keep on pretty much every single ClickUp just because I'm playing with them or we're building templates with them or something like that. Here, I just want to keep things simple and easier to use. And ClickApps are one of the main differences between having spaces break things up versus having folders break things up, besides, you know, a pretty avatar. So this is the reason I decided to break it out into its own space, besides just the aesthetics of having that separate icon and having that separate kind of collapsible toggle to keep everything together. When I'm actually in my workday, in case you're curious, I usually keep this space hidden, which I don't know if you guys knew that you could do that. So that way it's just kind of tucked out of the way. Like currently I have my workspaces hidden. So that way this one is the only one showing. So it's not essential to have it in its own space because you could just make the folder itself private, but it's a nice to have if you want to keep things a little bit cleaner. Now, I hope just by watching this, you're able to see kind of how you could very easily whip up a personal life organization system inside ClickUp in its own space, in your main space, whatever works for you. But what is the actual substance that you put in that? Well, you could copy some of the tasks that you were able to see on my screen, but just to give you a bit more of a running start into figuring out what should be on your adulting list, here are 12 example tasks you might want to consider having inside your adulting area in ClickUp. 1, change your water filter every 3 months. 2, get a haircut every X weeks. 3, sharpen your kitchen knives. 4, check vehicle fluids and spare tire. 5, and this is for my Americans out there who have to deal with this crazy credit report system, every 9 months, pull one credit report. Have each of the 3 different credit report agencies on a 9-month repeating cycle and check those reports every 9 months. 6, vehicle inspection. 7, vehicle registration. 8, clean out your medicine cabinet for expired medicines. 9, passport renewal. 10, dentist appointment. 11, clean out your gutters. 12, change water filter in your coffee maker. Obviously, all of these ones I talked about here are gonna be tasks that you're probably gonna wanna have as recurring tasks. And if you don't know how to set up recurring tasks in ClickUp, check out this playlist where I talk about not only what recurring tasks are, but also some common FAQs about setting up recurring tasks like these ones to make your life a little easier. Now, I realized that was our 12 promised adulting task suggestions, but as I was sitting here, I realized we actually have like 70 tasks in our own personal workspace as a simple 2-person household. So I figured I'd give you a few more suggestions just while I'm sitting here. So 5 bonus ones for those of you who hung around. Bonus 1, file your taxes. That's a good timely one for those of us who have 1099s or have quarterly taxes or have sales tax or have any other ridiculous US taxes. You can now remember to do them by having them recur in your ClickUp account. That is the only way I remember to do anything related to taxes. So recommend you do the same. Bonus 2, if you have pets, odds are they require maintenance of some kind. So whether it's nail trims or monthly medications, get them on a recurring task for yourself so you can make sure you're a decent dog parent or animal parent or human parent. I guess that's also a thing. 15 is a simple but sweet one. Change your toothbrush. There you go, not much more there, but that is one that you're gonna thank me for later. 16, kind of a specific one, but one I wanna shout out, buy a new motorcycle helmet. So this applies mostly to my spouse who has a motorcycle helmet, right? And I think it's a 10-year or a 5-year recurrence that we have on that. But there are probably things in your life too that are technically, you know, you buy them once and you keep them forever, but they do have a useful life. And so if you have anything like that, especially if it's a safety, a piece of equipment for safety, put a recurring task, almost like a database, to track the wear and tear of those items. Because the last thing you want is to realize after you got in a motorcycle accident that your helmet had actually been kind of at the end of its useful life the year prior. Last but not least, every single year, make a task to argue with your cable company, because that's the only way you will ensure that you don't get a 10% increase in price every single January. So this is for all of you Comcast folks out there, but I'm sure this applies to just about every bill that we all have. So there you go. This was 17 different tasks you could have to manage your adulting in the structure we talked about to manage your adulting, all within your ClickUp account, which could be even on a free account and with your spouse, with your partner, with your kids, whoever else you need to manage your, you know, humanity with. And hopefully this was a helpful video for you guys. If you have any more questions or you want to learn more about the personal side of using ClickUp, just let me know. Oh, and while you're down there, give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment, even just to say hi and click subscribe and the bell. Those kinds of actions cost you nothing, but they help this video reach a lot more people in the YouTube weird technical algorithm. I don't know, just do it because why not? I'll see you guys back here next Wednesday for another video about using ClickUp to organize your processes and, because it's January, to do all of that stuff in the effort of having a more productive personal life. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, enjoy the process.